Braintree Dems welcome the candidates for state auditor, Senator Diana DiSoglio and Chris Dempsey. First, we'll hear from Diana DiSoglio. Diana?
Thank you. We're good to go?
Yes, good to go.
Okay, perfect. Thank you so much, Madam Chair. Hey, everybody. Great to see you virtually this evening. Thanks so much for taking time out of your busy schedules to hear from all of us and for the work you do to elect Democrats up and down the ballot. We're so grateful. My name is Diana DiSoglio. I'm a state senator from the Merrimack Valley. A little bit about myself. I do not come from a well-connected political family. I was born to a 17-year-old single mom in the city of Methuen. We moved back and forth between Methuen and Lawrence throughout my childhood, depending on where my mom could find work as a young nurse's aide. I ended up going through the public school system here and then off to Middlesex Community College, where I was able to obtain an associate's degree that was affordable thanks to our Democratic legislature's investments in families like mine. And I then ended up earning a seat at Wellesley College, where I was so grateful to attend, but the only reason why I was able to actually attend there was because of a full financial scholarship. And I think it's important to mention that because it really was due to those financial investments made into my future success that I was able to actually see some success. And knowing that inspired me to give back in whatever way I could. So I went into community service working to help uplift struggling families through nonprofit work, which led me eventually to a position at the State House, working in the House of Representatives, providing constituent services. And I first actually ran for office a little over 10 years ago after what was actually a very tumultuous circumstance on Beacon Hill, where I was working at the time as a legislative aide in the House of Representatives. I was sexually harassed there and then subsequently dismissed because of that harassment. And in order to collect a standard severance package upon my departure, I was required to sign a taxpayer-funded non-disclosure agreement that prevented me from telling anyone about what I'd seen and witnessed behind those closed doors up on Beacon Hill. But I didn't let them get rid of me or keep me quiet, and I didn't leave government like they told me to do. I instead decided to run for state rep myself, and a little over a year later made my way back into that same chamber as the youngest woman serving in the House of Representatives at that time. And when I got elected, friends, I took that responsibility incredibly seriously. I knew it was incumbent upon me to take what I had learned through my experiences to help and fight for others in our communities who, like my family was, and maybe for completely different reasons, but for who, like my family was, have either been ignored or dismissed or disenfranchised by a system in state government that's just not working for all families in Massachusetts the way that it could and the way that it should. I took on the Beacon Hill establishment and fought for accessibility, diversity, equity, transparency, and accountability. Fought to ban the use of those taxpayer-funded non-disclosure agreements. That's a fight that I took with me to the state Senate, where I'm proud to say we've unanimously passed a complete ban on the abuse of those agreements using your tax dollars. But we have a Republican administration, friends, who continues to dig their heels in on this simple matter of transparency and accountability and in so many other areas concerning your tax dollars. When Governor Baker diverted vaccines away from our local communities and our elderly, disabled, immunocompromised, and those without transportation suffered as a result, I stood up and demanded equity and accountability from the governor and called for an investigation into the millions of taxpayer dollars he spent on no-bid contracts with friends in the private sector instead of reinvesting those dollars into our local communities where families could get equitable access. When we found out that the governor told falsehoods about what really caused the Holyoke Soldiers Home tragedy, I again stood up and called for a full investigation and oversight hearing by the Senate, demanding that the governor come back under oath and that we use our full subpoena authority to get to the bottom of what really happened, because the families of those who lost loved ones deserve justice. As state auditor, I won't need to keep calling for audits and demanding investigations. I'll take my nearly 10 years of fighting for accountability and transparency, and I will investigate and I will audit these matters and much more on your behalf. We know that sunlight is the best disinfectant, but for as forward-thinking as we claim to be here in the state of Massachusetts, we continue to be ranked by every good government group as the least transparent state government in the entire nation. I know that we can do better, that we can meet our goals to help working families across this Commonwealth, but it's going to take shining a light in the dark areas of our state government, exposing where the gaps exist, and then working alongside of advocates like yourself to promote meaningful change. Once again, my name is Diana DeZoglio. I respectfully ask for your support at convention. I can't do this without you. Please feel free to contact me. I'm going to put my contact information in the chat and my cell phone as well if you want to give me a call or a text to follow up about what's important to you in this race. I'd love to have that conversation and work hard for your support. Thanks so much, Madam Chair, for the opportunity to be here tonight.
Thank you very much for joining us tonight, and we wish you the best of luck. Next, we welcome Chris Dempsey, candidate for state auditor.
Kathy, thanks so much for having me tonight. And Kathy, thank you for such a well-run Democratic town committee in Braintree. You guys do a great job. I know that in the past when I've visited, you put up videos and made sure that they're shared. And that community building is so important. And I think it's clear in the results in your turnout tonight for this caucus. So thank you for all that you do. My name is Chris Dempsey. I'm running for Massachusetts State Auditor because I believe that Massachusetts is the greatest state in the country and we deserve a state government to match. As State Auditor, I'll bring my experience working within state government to make it work better for all of us and standing up to protect the public interest. But I'll also bring my experience as the son of public school teachers. My parents met while teaching at the Martin Luther King School in Boston in 1970. A math teacher and a social studies teacher were placed in adjoining classrooms, and it was love at first sight. That's my mom's version of the story, at least. My dad's version of the story. My mom is not so convinced that it was love at first sight. I have seen some photos of how my dad dressed in 1970. I can understand what my mom's reservations might have been. I will also tell you that my wonderful fiance Anna tells me that fashion sense runs in the family, so I don't quite know what to make about that. But eventually my parents got together and I was the result of that happy marriage, along with my little sister Allison, who's also a public school teacher. And I grew up seeing my parents making decisions to dig into their own pockets to pay for school supplies for their students, as we know so many public school teachers still do to this day across the Commonwealth. And when you see that firsthand, you ask some basic questions about why we are spending money in some areas of government while others are going lacking. That led me to a career in and around public service. As Assistant Secretary of Transportation for Governor Deval Patrick, I co-founded the MassDOT program that created all of the smartphone applications that tell you when your bus or your train is going to arrive. Now, as Red Line riders, you know that we didn't fix the more fundamental problem of actually making sure those trains run on time. But at least you now have the power of that information in the palm of your hands. We made the MBTA the very first transit agency on the entire East Coast to make those apps available to riders. So briefly, we made the MBTA an innovative place. I'm proud to share with you that Governor Patrick has made a max contribution to our campaign, his first max contribution to any candidate in Massachusetts in over a decade. I've also stood up to protect the public interest, and that's a core part of this job. You will all remember back in 2014 and 2015, a proposal to bring the Olympics to Boston in the summer of 2024. And that bid was backed by the most powerful business leaders in Massachusetts, some of the most powerful elected officials. But they were asking all of us as state taxpayers to sign a guarantee to cover 100% of the cost overruns of the Olympic Games, 100%. And that meant spending billions on a 3-week sporting event instead of on public schools and public education and public transportation and so many other needs. I stood up as a founder of No Boston Olympics to make sure that taxpayers and all of us as residents had a voice in that process. And even though we got outspent 1,500-1 on that campaign, we were successful because we had the facts and the data on our side, and we built a grassroots effort that so many of you were a part of. By the end of that campaign, we had more individual contributors to our campaign than Boston 2024 had to its campaign. My takeaway from that effort is that when you put good information in front of the people of Massachusetts, we tend to be a pretty savvy bunch. We tend to get things right. And that's the job of the state auditor: dig into the executive branch, figure out what's working and what's not working and how things need to change, and then make the case within state government so that we can build a stronger Commonwealth for all of us. We know that state government isn't doing enough to address high housing prices, the climate crisis, the student debt crisis, the opioid crisis, the list goes on and on. Let me share one example of how the auditor's office can help. As state auditor, I'll make the office the first in the country to incorporate carbon accounting into our audits of relevant state agencies. And that will allow us to hold those agencies accountable for the laws that are on the books that require them to reduce emissions. I promise you, we will be the first auditor's office in the country to do this, but we will not be the last. We will make the office a national leader on climate through this approach. I live in the first floor of a triple decker with my fiance, Anna, about two blocks from where I grew up. We are looking forward to starting and building a family together in the years ahead. And we want to do that in the best Massachusetts that we can have. And that means having the best state government that we can have. That's why I'm running for this role, bringing my experience in the public sector, in the private sector, and in the nonprofit sector. I ask for your support at tonight's caucus and at the convention in June. I applaud you all for being a part of this important grassroots process. And I thank you again for your time tonight. Please join us at dempseyforauditor.com. Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight.